Hello, YouTube and YouTubettes. Welcome to an album review. I have a very special formula that I use to make grades, so you will hear fractions and like a 5.73 or whatever. I won't give that away, but in this video, I would like to review the Beach Boys album Surfer Girl, released on September 16th, 1963 on Capitol Records. The Wilson's father, Murray Wilson, was still the manager, and this was the first album that gave Brian Wilson credit as the producer, although he was probably very involved in the producing in the first two albums as well. Engineer was Chuck Britz. This album, I think, was a step forward artistically. The album cover is interesting, taken by Capitol photographer Ken Veeder, the same photo shoot as Surf and Safari. And it's a classic photo of the Beach Boys holding a surfboard. And I don't really care for this one as much as the Surf and Safari front cover. And it's a shame that they used older photos for an album a year, actually. So I give this one a 6 out of 10 on the front cover. Now on to the songs. The first song on the album is Surfer Girl, written by Brian Wilson. This was actually the first song Brian ever wrote, and he was in the car listening to a song called When You Wish Upon a Star, that famous Disney song, and you can kind of hear some of the melody influenced on this song. I don't know why he didn't release it earlier. I think it was actually recorded in the Candix label before they were signed to Capitol, but this was an approved version of it. I heard that he was somewhat ashamed of his falsetto voice, and so to release something like this as a single to the world or to the nation was not appealing to him at the time, or he was a little bit reluctant to do that. But he finally did with this one, and it was a pretty big hit. This one does pretty well across the board. Nothing, no tens, but lots of sevens, eights, and nines. And I give this song a 7.8 out of 10. Catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world. Don't be the next song is Catch a Wave by Brian Wilson and Mike Love. Sung by Brian, or sung mostly by Mike, and then Brian comes in and adds some. Mike, I heard, had a cold during these recording sessions, and so his voice sounds a little bit rougher. In fact, some people might confuse him with Dennis Wilson on this song, but it's Mike Love singing, and this is probably my favorite surf song that they ever did. It's got some nice organ sounds and some harp that I believe was played by Mike Love's sister. This is a great song all the way around, and it's got some nice, great production, and it's catchy, and it's artistic, I think. And I give this one an 8.6 out of 10. The next song is Surfer Moon, written by Brian Wilson, and this is a underrated song, kind of a deep cut. This was an artistic piece. You listen to the production of it and the instrumentations, and this one is, I think, ahead of its time for the Beach Boys, and you start to get hints of more of the symphonic type of instrumentation that Brian would start doing more of. This one's a little less catchy, but it's still a very nice song. I give it a 7.6 out of 10. Look out, here come the next song is South Bay Surfer. The music was written by Stephen Foster, based on the music for Swanee River. And the lyrics were by Brian Wilson, Carl Wilson, and Al Jardine. It'd be interesting to know who wrote what. But I think it's interesting that Al Jardine's name is here, given that he left the group right before they were signed to Capitol, and as far as I know, didn't come back as a full-fledged member until one or two albums after this. But Brian did stop touring for a while in 1963, and Al Jardine came back to replace Brian. So David Marks was still around. So there was a period there where Al and Dave were in the band together back in the early 60s, which is kind of interesting. But Al was not an official member at this point, but I guess he was still connected with the guys at this time. It's kind of a weaker song in my opinion, and I give this a 4.0 out of 10. The next song is The Rocking Surfer. It was a traditional arranged by Brian Wilson. This is one of my favorite surf instrumentals that they did. And according to some research by somebody else, it says that the Good Humor Melody, it's called a Good Humor Melody, used in Southern California was based on a Polish or maybe Czechoslovakian folk melodies called Stodola Pumpa or Stodola Pampa. I remember looking this up at one point and listening to it, and I couldn't really hear this in that track. But anyway, that's a little interesting on what this song was. But I think this is a very happy, surfy kind of organ-based surf instrumental as opposed to guitar-based. And since it's a cover, it doesn't do as high, but I give it a 6.7 out of 10. The next song is Little Deuce Coupe by Brian Wilson and Roger Christian, sung mostly by Mike Love. And this is not one of my favorite Beach Boys songs. It sounds kind of like a country song to me, musically. Roger Christian was a radio personality and seemed to know a lot about cars, so Brian would use him to write songs about cars. And he also wrote some songs for Jan and Dean. That's an interesting fact about Roger Christian. It gets high numbers on the catchiness side. I'm just not a big fan of this song, and it does lower on the artistic side, but I give it a 7.6 out of 10. Beginning on Side B is In My Room, written by Brian Wilson and Gary Usher. This is a beautiful song, and the lyrics are a step up from where they had been in the past. In a sense, Brian has said this, and it's true, that it's kind of a biography about his life. I think Gary Usher may have written the words, but I don't know for sure. Maybe Gary Usher wrote the music and Brian wrote the words, but it sounds like Brian Wilson type music as well. But this is a very artistic piece. Once again, you can hear the harp, and it's played by Mike Love's sister, and her name is Maureen Love. So this one gets high marks, very consistent marks across the board. It's not as catchy, so that brings the score down a little bit. But it's a beautiful song, great lyric, and I give it a 7.8 out of 10. Do you wanna go straight to Hawaii? Hawaii. Straight to Hawaii. The next song is Hawaii, written by Brian Wilson and Mike Love, and it's sung by Brian with Mike. And this is a very catchy song. It's not one that I really like that much. I will say that the vocal arrangements are pretty cool. Not a very artistic song, and I give this one a 6.8 out of 10. It's a genuine fact that the surfers rule. It's plastered on the next song is Surfers Rule, written by Brian Wilson and Mike Love, sung by Dennis along with Brian Wilson. This is a catchy song. I love the intro to the song, but then it gets into the verses, and I'm not a big fan of the verses so much, but whenever it does the "it's a genuine fact that the surfers rule" section, I think it's really cool, vocal arrangement, and it has kind of a garage rock sound at the beginning. But overall, I'm not a big fan of the song. I do like the reference to the Four Seasons at the end of it. I haven't heard the Beach Boys talk much about the Four Seasons in interviews, but they do talk about them in the song, and it's kind of like East or West versus East. So, like I said, there's some parts of the song that I really like, but the verses in general I'm not a big fan of. Overall, this song gets a 6.0 out of 10. Next is Our Car Club, written by Brian Wilson and Mike Love. And it sounds like a very familiar jazz kind of song. And I really like the way they use it in this. They probably should have given somebody else credit to the music, but it's really cool. It's something a little different than what they've normally done. Mike Love singing lead on this. And it does very well, with the exception of lyrical poetry. And I give this song a 6.8 out of 10. We now go to Your Summer Dream, written by Brian Wilson and Bob Norberg. Beautiful song. It has some rhythm guitar at the beginning that is unusual for them for a ballad, since they're normally either piano or some sort of symphonic instruments. But this one has more of a guitar sound at the beginning, along with Brian's voice, which sounds really nice. This is a deep cut, a very underrated song, a very beautiful and artistic and a very poetic lyric. And I give this song a 7.2 out of 10. The last song is an instrumental called Boogie Woody, a traditional arranged by Brian Wilson. Definitely the traditional is that it's based on the Boogie Woogie. And so this is kind of that's basically all it is, but they kind of gave it the Beach Boys flavor, I guess, to make it a surf song. The only complaint, it's a fun little song, and it's not one that I particularly care for that much, but it is a catchy cover. My main complaint is that Your Summer Dream should have been the close of the album and not Boogie Woody. You know, this is what they decided to do. So Brian was playing piano on this, and I give it a 6.3 out of 10. The album flow, I give a 10 out of 10, and this is just a very solid production by Brian Wilson for 1963. So now I will pull out my handy dandy computer and calculate my formula. And this album gets a 7.09 out of 10. Thank you and have a wonderful day.